you are doing good and safe at home. Welcome back to our English class. Let's start our English class with what? Yes, very good. With a word of the day. Okay? Word of the day. Every day we are learning a word and its meaning, right? Last class we have learned a word. Do you remember that? Very good. Say Cupids, right? Cupids. What is the meaning? Abundant or many, plentiful, numerous, ample, right? Okay. Today I will introduce a new word. Okay? What is this? Read this word. D-A-W-D-L-E. Dawdle. Am I right? Say this. Dawdle. Are you sure? But that is wrong. Dawdle. Say dawdle. Okay, here we are writing A, but we have to pronounce this dawdle. Okay, the correct pronunciation is dawdle. Say dawdle. D-A-W-D-L-E. Dawdle. Say louder. Dawdle. Once again, dawdle. Okay, what is the meaning dawdle? What is the meaning of this word dawdle? Waste time. Okay, wasting time. And be slow. Okay, two meanings are there. Waste time or else be slow. Okay, waste time then be slow. Which word? Dawdle. Dawdle. What is the meaning? Waste time and be slow. Got it? Yes. See, wasting time. Okay, that is called dawdle. We are doing this, right? Always we are dawdle. Am I right? Yes. See, for example, she mustn't dawdle. She had to write the exam quickly. Okay? She must not. Okay, mustn't means must not. Okay, must plus not. She must not dawdle, which means she should not waste her time. Okay, she should not be slow. She had to write the exam quickly. Okay, when we write exam, we waste all our time. At the end, we write quickly. Am I right? Yes or no? Yes, that is dawdle. Okay, dawdle means waste of time. Wasting time and also be slow. Okay? She must not dawdle. She had to write the exam quickly. Okay? She must not dawdle. She had to write the exam quickly. Okay? Have you got it? You must not dawdle. Okay? You have to write 5 sentences quickly now. Got it? That means you should not waste your time. You have to write 5 sentences by using this word dawdle. Am I right? Yes or no? Yes, that is dawdle. Okay, waste time, be slow. Got it? She must not dawdle. She had to write the exam quickly. Okay, did you understand? What is the word dawdle? What is the meaning? Waste time or be slow. Okay? Yes. Now, let's move on to our lesson. What a lesson we are learning, do you remember? Very good. Children of the digital age. Okay? Children of the digital age. What theme we are learning from this lesson? Very good. Digitalization has changed the way we live. Okay, the technology and the gadgets changed our lifestyle. Am I right? Yes. Then we have started a story. Do you remember that? Who was in that train? Grandma or grandpa? Very good. Grandma. Whose grandma? Gunal and Sonal's grandma. Right? Yes. Then what happened in the beginning? Yes, when the train checked into the platform, that children were waiting for their granny, right? That granny, she get down from that train and she asked sorry to the children. children, right? She thought they are waiting for 3 hours in that sunny platform. Okay. Then afterwards, the children said, "No, Granny, just 2 minutes before we reached the station because we know everything through our mobile phone. When did you come? Okay. When will you reach here? Everything we know through our mobile phone. So we came just 2 minutes before in the railway station." That Granny was shocked and surprised, right? Really? Do you have all these things in your mobile phone? Like that, she was surprised and shocked. Okay? Usually, in some years back, if we want to go anywhere, we have to book the tickets in queue, right? Then we have to know the anticipating arrival of the train, then waitlisted everything in the railway station only. But nowadays, with the help of our mobile phone, we can check all those things in our place itself. Am I right? Yes. Then I told you about an app, application. Do you remember that? Yes. Where is my train? Okay. With the help of that application, we can know which station we reached, then when will we reach the exact destination, everything we know. Right? Yes. Then afterwards, that Granny asked about their driver, right? That car. But the children said their driver is on a leave, so we have to book a cab. Then that Granny, again she was shocked and asked, "You are two small children till now in your teens, but how can you how can you book a taxi?" Then that children said, "No, Granny, we no need to go anywhere. We can book the cab through our mobile phone itself." Okay? Then they booked the car. That car's name is sedan. Okay, a white car which has 4 doors and there are some place to keep all the things. Okay, luggages. Then what happened? That Gunal, he said, "Okay, I will ask that location, okay, location to the driver, we can coordinate with him." Okay, till that we have learnt. Do you remember? Then we have learnt some new words. What are they? Chucked, screeching halt, tracking, online, portal, anticipating, waitlisted, sedan, then coordinate. Okay? Today, let's learn the remaining part. I want all the students to take your book, open it, page number 46. Page number 46. Have you all taken? Listen the audio, then look at your book also. Okay? Take your pencil, then underline the hard words. Okay? Are you ready to listen? Yes. Take your book, listen the audio carefully, then underline the hard words. Okay?
You know all these details about the cab on your mobile phone. But what if he misleads us with the wrong route or takes a long route to earn extra money? The first time I came to Delhi with your grandfather, almost 50 years ago, we took a horse carriage from the railway station to go to a relative's place and did not find the address for 2 hours. The driver of the carriage fleeced us. I was so afraid in such a big city.
Granny, don't worry. I have the location on my mobile phone. I just checked the shortest route to go home, avoiding most of the rush hour traffic congestion. The app on my mobile phone through GPS too does this. So, we save time, fuel and money. And surely we won't get lost at all.
Winked Kunal, with Sonal winking back.
You mean your phone knows your exact location on this earth?
Of course, Granny. I just shared all the details with Dad. So, Dad, Mom and Grandpa know exactly what time we'll reach and they will be ready with breakfast.
Said Kunal.
Have you all read the text? Did you underline the hard words? Okay. See, did you understand anything from that? No? Okay. That Granny, she saying that, okay, all right, everything you know or everything you're having, all the details in your mobile phone, okay, I agree. But one more thing, if the driver misleads us to a wrong route, or else if the driver takes a long route to earn money, what will you do? Okay, if the driver takes us to the wrong route or the long route, okay, one wrong route, then another one long, okay, long route, what will you do? Who was asking that? That granny, okay. 50 years back, that granny and grandpa, they went to Delhi, okay. At that time, they booked a horse carriage, okay, they called a horse carriage to go to their relative's house, okay, where? In Delhi, okay. But they didn't find that exact address for 2 hours, okay. The driver was cheated them, okay. Fleeced, which means cheated. Fleeced means cheated, okay. The driver of the carriage was fleeced them. Fleeced means cheated. So from that onwards, I'm very scared in this big city. Who said like that? That granny, okay. That granny was asking. Sometimes the driver misleads us to in a wrong route, or he takes a long route to earn money. What will you do? Okay, once before 50 years, we who are granny and grandpa, they came to Delhi. At that time, from the railway station, they called a horse carriage to go to their relative's house. But for 2 hours, they couldn't find that exact address. Okay, that driver, the driver of that carriage was fleeced them. Fleeced means cheated them. Okay, so from that onwards, that granny was so afraid in that big city. Like that, she was sharing her experience. Who? That granny. To whom? The children, Gunal and Sona. Okay, then she was asking, what will you do? If they do like this, what will you do? Okay, children said, no granny, don't worry. Okay, no granny, don't worry. I have location on. Okay, this is an option. Location on my mobile phone. Okay, who said? Gunal was saying this. Okay, no granny, don't worry. I have location on my mobile phone. Okay, with the use of GPS. GPS, full form, Global Positioning System. Okay, Global Positioning System. Say, Global Positioning System. GPS. Okay, with the help of GPS, in this option, location on, we can check the shortest route. Okay, shortest route, it will avoid us from the heavy congestion. Okay, congestion, that means full of traffic. Okay, so that we can go in a short way. Got it? With the help of GPS. GPS does this work. Okay, so in that location on, in that option, that Gunal has found that short route, okay, short route with the help of GPS. Okay, so the children were saying to their grandma, so don't worry, okay, no granny, don't worry about that. Who said that? Children. Okay, then Gunal was winked. Winked means winked, close and open eye quickly. Okay, one, close and open one eye quickly. Okay, that is called winked. Okay, Gunal, he winked first, then Sonal also winked her eyes. Okay, winked means close and open eye quickly. Have you got it? Yes. One more thing, this GPS, Global Positioning System, right? Global Positioning System, which means it's a signal came from satellite. Okay, signal came from satellite. It's used to position, know the position of person or any other things. Okay, that is called GPS. Okay, it's a signal came from satellite. Okay, we can use this to know the position of some person, thing or something. Okay, then that granny was saying that, so you have all the things, you know, all the things are in a mobile phone and we can know the location on earth, all the location on the earth. Am I right? Who asked? That granny. Okay, then the children said, yes granny, now I share the location to my daddy also. Okay, so daddy, mummy and grandpa all are waiting for us. They know the exact time of our reach. Okay, they know, so they are waiting for us with the breakfast. Who said that? Children. Okay, dear children, did you understand this? Should we recall once? Okay, see, last class we have learned up to that children book, the cab, right? Okay, then that granny was saying that, okay, you know all the details about the cab from your mobile phone. Sometimes if the driver misleads us to a wrong route or else he takes a long route to earn money, what will you do? Okay, then she shared about her experience. Before 50 years, she and her husband, okay, their grandpa, both of them went to Delhi. Okay, from the railway station, they called a horse carriage, okay, to go to their relative's house. At that time, that driver of that carriage fleeced means cheated them. Okay, for 2 hours, they couldn't find out that exact address. So that granny was saying that, so I'm very scared in this big city. Okay, so Gunnar said, no granny, don't worry, I have location on my mobile phone, so that we can check the short route. Okay, we can check the short route, it will avoid us from the congestion, traffic congestion, full of traffic. Okay, congestion means full of traffic. Okay, it will save us from the traffic also, so we can go home quickly. Okay, who said? Gunal. Then he said all these things done because of GPS. GPS means global positioning system. Okay, which means a signal passed by satellites. Okay, with the use of this we can know the position of some person or thing or something. Okay, that is GPS. Okay, GPS does this work. Who said? Gunal. And Gunal winked his eyes. Winked means close and open one eye quickly. Okay, that is called winked. He winked his eyes. That at that time his sister Sonal also winking her eye. Okay, then the granny was saying that, oh, that means your mobile phone knows your location on this earth, right? Yeah, then that children said, yes granny, I shared the link to that location to my daddy also. So daddy, mummy and grandpa all are waiting for us with the breakfast. Okay, they know the exact time of our reach. So they are waiting for us. They are waiting for us with breakfast. Who said? Guna. Okay, now let's watch the animation video of this part. Are you ready? Yes. Dear students, while you are watching that video, you should listen the audio also. Okay, it will help for your reading. Okay, afterwards read the text. Got it? Are you ready? Yes.
Chapter 4, Children of the Digital Age. Let us read this story on how technology and gadgets have changed our lives.
The train chugged in at the railway platform and came to a screeching halt.
Kunal, Sonal, I am so sorry that you had to wait for 3 hours at the platform to receive me. The train kept getting late,
said Granny as she got down and hugged the two children tightly.
No, Granny, we reached the station only 2 minutes ago. We knew the exact arrival time of your train. Kunal has been tracking the train all the stations you crossed and at what time online on his mobile phone.
Said Sonal.
Really? How? I was so worried that you both were waiting at the station in the summer heat.
Granny, the railway inquiry online portal gives live updates on all trains. So, no more endless wait games. I can even book or cancel tickets instantly standing right here.
Said Kunal.
How nice. You know, your grandfather and I have spent endless hours waiting in queues to first book tickets and then anticipating train arrivals. Earlier, we got to know things like arrival status and ticket confirmation of waitlisted seats only when we reached the railway station. Later on, the railway inquiry telephone number started giving an estimate of the delays. Times have changed, all for the good. Let's head home. Where is the car parked?
Granny, the driver is on leave today. I'll just book a cab.
Said Sonal.
Cab? You both came in a taxi by yourself? You both are still children. Hardly in your teens.
Granny, relax. I'm booking a cab through my mobile phone app. See, it is showing that a cab is available just a minute away. It's a white sedan, so we'll fit in comfortably with your luggage. It will cost us around 300 rupees and we should reach home in about 55 minutes. I'll just call the cab driver and coordinate on the exact pickup location at the exit gate.
Said Kunal.
You know all these details about the cab on your mobile phone. But what if he misleads us with the wrong route or takes a long route to earn extra money? The first time I came to Delhi with your grandfather, almost 50 years ago, we took a horse carriage from the railway station to go to a relative's place and did not find the address for 2 hours. The driver of the carriage fleeced us. I was so afraid in such a big city.
Granny, don't worry. I have the location on my mobile phone. I just checked the shortest route to go home, avoiding most of the rush hour traffic congestion. The app on my mobile phone through GPS too does this. So, we save time, fuel and money. And surely we won't get lost at all.
Winked Kunal, with Sonal winking back.
You mean your phone knows your exact location on this earth?
Of course, Granny. I just shared all the details with Dad. So, Dad, Mom and Grandpa know exactly what time we'll reach and they will be ready with breakfast.
Said Kunal.
Dear students, read this text again and again, then underline the hard words, study the meanings, okay? Then study the spelling also. Try to make 5 sentences by using the word of the day, okay? Shall we meet in next class? Yes. Bye-bye.